In this video, we are going to see how to use the web control used for uploading a file. So we are going to see in this how the user can upload, how the user can, the developer can create an upload form, and then how it will be uploaded. So that is the concept we are going to see, how you can use the HTML upload file format, and then that will be sent to the PHP where it will be processed. So that is what we are going to see here. So it allows the users to upload files from your form, and it will be very useful. Now we'll see. Already you should have seen like this. See here. When you run this here upload file, then you have to browse. When you click the browse, then the folder will come. You can select the folder and select the file, and then send by pressing the send file, you can upload it. This is the concept. So how you can do it from the HTML file. So we have given the name as phpfile.html, and we have used the following tags, HTML tags, and within you have to write within the form and close form. So form equal to the form has the following parameters. Here we have added one more thing called enc type other than the action and method. A method is post and action is PHP style file, that is .php. This is a HTML file. Since I have given the same name, phpfile.php. So enc type multiport form hyphen data. If you give this argument, it will accept any type of file. It may be a PNG file, it may be a PDF file, it may be a Word file. So it will accept all type of format. So that is why we have given multiport form hyphen data. So this argument you can give. Now, then upload file. So this is a caption which is coming here. So here we write upload file. Then we are using the tag called input name equal to, we have given a name for that. So whatever is uploaded, that will be stored in this variable. Then this is what we are going to access from the PHP side, where the file name will be stored in this variable. Then type equal to file. When you give the type equal to file, this facility will be done. So automatically this control and this control will come. Sorry, this control will come. That is nothing but browse control. Then whatever you have selected, that will be selected. And using send file, you can send that file to the PHP file which you have given here for the processing of the data. So input type submit. So this is a submit button. Okay. So when you execute this, your HTML file runs like this. Then from PHP side, what are we going to process? So we are going to read the file what we have uploaded. So here, when you upload it, it will be stored in a temporary file name. Whatever the uploaded file, that will be stored in a TMP folder with a temporary file name. So where it is stored? So already, as I said, it is stored in the temporary file name. And here we are reading that file. Whatever we have uploaded, that we are going to read it. So here what happens, even if time being you don't understand, I just explain this coding. When coming to the file operations, we will see that in detail. So first, F open is for file opening, because we have stored now that file. And dollar files, user file. So user file is the one which we have used as a variable for the file which is uploaded here. So this will have the name php password.php, whatever we have selected there. So that from the, with the temporary name. So that will be taken and in a read mode. In the second argument, it has fopen has two arguments. The first is the file name and second is the file mode. Read, write, execute, both read and write like that. Here we are going to just read the file which we have stored. So we have given it as read mode. Then while, FEOF means end of the file. So till it not reached. So this is a handle. So to the variable right hand side, you use the F open. So that now pointer will be pointing to this file, which is opened here. Then till it reaches the end of the file. So for that, we have to keep on reading. So it starts from the starting of the file till it reaches the end of the file. So what we have given is till it not reaches the end of the file. We have given the file handle so that now that will be started reading. Text equal to, so here we are using a temporary variable where we used to read the line by line. So fgetS is used to read line by line to sentence. Say fgetS then handle. So it will whatever is given, it read line by line, and first line it will be stored in text, then here we are printing. Then again it go inside the loop, it recurs to the second line, read it and place it in the temporary variable text, and then we are printing it on the screen and so on. Finally, once it's done, we close the file. So this is the meaning of this. You'll see the output. So there we have read the password file, and the file, the reading of the file is whatever is present in the content that will be read, and it is echoed on the screen. Now we'll see another example which we have given name as psp file.html. Here the output will be like this. The label for file, file name. We have given the, we have used the tag called label for file and file name. So for this we have given like this, so that it will be neatly printed. And then here again we have this ntype multiport form data, like the previous one. Then we have used the file name upload file one. We are directing whatever we are getting as an input from the user to this. So input file name, file ID. We have given an ID for this. Then submit button. So once you execute this program, it will have this browse, and whatever you have selected, that will be coming in this text box. So for that we use the file name. Whereas if you see that here, it doesn't come. See here, only a browse button. So and whatever you have selected, that comes here. But here the difference between the label for us, when you use like this, then this text box will come. So whatever you selected, that will be appearing in the text box. Sorry, that is for this file name. Then once it is sent to that, we execute this following program. That is, the upload file will have this following content. So what is this? If the user has submitted the button, that is what we are checking here. Already we have seen is set. Is set is used to check whether a particular control has been clicked by or selected by the user. Here we are checking for the submit button. We assume that after the browse only they will press the submit button. So we check that, and then we inside that, if it is okay, then we go inside the if class. Then we store, we have a temporary variable called error, and we read any error if while uploading any error occurs, so that we can get it by using the variable $_files, which is exclusively for file concept. And then this is also a PHP global variable. And then the first argument will be the file, and the second argument will be the error. You have to give it as such. So when you give that, it will say if any error found in that uploaded file. So that will be stored. Then you are checking what error it is. There are nearly 7 error checks. So what are they? You'll see here. Upload error okay means there is no error. Okay. The error okay means there is no error. So the file uploaded is success. So another one is upload error INI size. The uploaded file exceeds the maximum file size, which is given in the php.ini, which is nothing but a configuration file. There, the maximum file size is mentioned. If the uploading file is exceeding that maximum size, it will give that. It will have this error. Then upload error form size. It is mentioned in the HTML. If the HTML has reached the maximum file size, then this error will take place. Then upload error partial. The file upload file was only partially uploaded. That is the message given. Then error no file. If the file was no uploaded, that is, if the user does not press the browse, or even if you press, he doesn't select anything and just press submit, then this will be indicated. That is, upload error no file will be stored in that left hand variable. That is here. Okay. Other variables, other things are error no tmpdir, missing a temporary folder. That folder may not be there. Then can't write, fail to write file to the disk. Then extension, php extension stop the file upload. So these are all the different types of error codes. Now we are using the first error code because we want to know whether it has been uploaded or not. If this comes, if this is the error code after executing the statement, this will consist of any one of this. So what we are interested is, we are checking whether the file is uploaded properly. So we have to check this. If it is equal to this, then file is uploaded successfully. So here what we do is we write the file name, display the file name. That is what here we are saying, phptext.php. We have selected that. So that file name. So how you can print that file name? By using this variable, $_files and then file, then name. If you give this automatically, whatever the user has selected in the browse, that will be printed. File uploaded successfully. And then here temporary name. While uploading, any file uploaded will have a temporary name. Automatically PHP server will create a temporary name and then only it will upload. So that will be given. That will be the temporary file location will be given. See here the output. File uploaded successfully and the where it is present. It is upload if OPT lamp under the folder temp. It will be given a temporary name and there it is stored. And we are displaying, and this is the full directory is path is given, so we give it, make it as a file location. We have given here as a file location. Then echo files file type. What type of file? Whether it is a PDF file or JPG file or Word file, etc. So here it is given application. It is a PHP is an application, so it is given the along with the extension. It is printing. So then file size. What is the size of the file? So here this is a file size that is also printed. Yes. If this becomes unsuccessful, other than this message, which means it is some error is there. So now here we give the information files picture PIC error uploading. This will be printed. Okay. Now by using the global PHP $files array, you can. This is an array. $files is an array where we have these values. You can upload files from a client computer to the remote server. So the second argument, first argument is the file, and the second argument is these things. That's what we have seen: name, type, size, TMP name, error, etc. The name of the uploaded file will be displayed, the type of the uploaded file, the size in bytes of the uploaded file. When you mention size, then TMP name, the name of the temporary copy of the file stored on the server, then error, the error code resulting from the file upload. That is what we are catching it here, and then we are checking inside. Okay. Already we have seen the error codes. Okay, now we'll see the restrictions of upload. What do you mean by restrictions of upload? Sometimes you may want to restrict the size of the file. The user are requested to, you may want to restrict that they have to write, can attach a file up to only 10 MB or 10 KB. Like that, we can restrict. Not only that, only this type of file you may want to address. Say for example, only picture files, that is JPG, PNG, only that, or only PDF files, or only Word file. You may want to restrict the user to upload only that type. So if they try to attach anything other than that, they will get an error. So you may want to do that validation. So in that case, you can have the file type checking, and then you can make the force the user to do that only. So here, if you see that, we can add restrictions to uploaded files like size, type of files, etc. We will see here. In the below program, the user can upload files of type .gif and JPEG and of size under 20 KB. Less than 20 KB only they can. If they try to upload a file which is more than 20 KB, then it will post an error. So here, again, we check for the submit button, whether the user has selected and submit. If the submit is done, then it will go inside the loop. So in it will have another class where we have that file type checking. We are checking whether the file type is equal to GIF, image and GIF, image and JPEG, and image and mini. Only these files we are accepting. So all these things are given with R. See double this symbol, vertical bar. So this vertical bar, double vertical bar will means either this or this or this. So only this, any one of this may be true, then it the if class is true. And so any one of this true, and means all these things, any one of this must be true. So here this left hand side must be true. All up to this will be considered as left hand side. And then this is the right hand side. And what is this? And size must be less than 20,000. So this we are checking. If it is true only, then it will go inside. what happens? While says error is also greater than zero. Why here we are checking greater than zero? We can use whether it is equal to this or what is our value returned by that? It is zero. If it returns zero, then there is no problem in uploading. That is what we are checking here. If it is greater than zero, then error in the file. Or if it is less than zero or equal to zero, then it is successfully uploaded. That is what the meaning. So if it is greater than zero, we have errors. So that error we are printing it here. Else, we say upload, then file name, file type, then file size. File size we are calculating in KB. So that can be done by division by, we get the size of the file and divide by 1024 will give you the size in KB. Then print the temporary name. So else, invalid file name. If it is not a image file or something like that, or more than that, then more than 20,000, then it bytes, it will give you the error. Invalid file, and then it calculate the size, and so that we can see what mistake it is. If it is invalid file, then we can understand that it is a not a image file. So if it is more than that also, we can understand by displaying the size by dividing it by 1024. So here if you see invalid file and the size is this, even if I have uploaded a JPEG file, since the size is more than that, it gives me the invalid file. See here, I have uploaded. This is successful. But another one, again, the same I have tried, where it gives me the invalid file. Now, saving the uploaded file and moving it to a particular location. You can save the uploaded file by using move uploaded file function. How it can be done? The general syntax of that function is, it returns a Boolean variable, whether true or false. So move underscore uploaded underscore file, then file name and the destination. First will be the file name, where you are moving, that will be given in the destination. Now we'll see the program. Here again, you have this your check submit, then you give restrictions. But here instead of 20,000, we have given up to 30,000. And then what we are doing is it greater than, if the error is more than zero, means there is some error. Okay, so error. If it is equal to zero only, means there is no error. And this will be executed. If there is an error, then this will be printed. And then what we are doing is, we are going to display the information like what is the file name, what's the type, size, and then in which file name it is stored. Then we check if the file exists. Okay, if it is exists in that upload, then for example, if we might have uploaded the same file again and again. So in that case, it will say that it is already exists. It will check. That is what here it checks. File exists will help you to check whether the file is already existing. We might have run this program already, and again we are trying to upload the same file. In that case, this checking will take place. That is OPT slam. It will check whether in this upload, the file name which we have, it's there. If it is there, then it say already exists. Else, the file is moved to the particular folder. So for that, what we have to do is already, you know, we are executing our file under the htdocs, under the php.rgs. So there you have to create a file, a folder called upload. So before executing this program, you have to create a folder called upload under this, and then you have to give the full path name here. So here what we are doing, move upload file, here first source and then destination. So what is the source? Temporary file is the source. Then where we are moving to this file, and dot is concatenation. You are concatenating this file name. Then echo stored in. Now we would like to know whether it is stored there. So echo stored in. And then we just again print the whole path and then the file name. Else, if nothing happened, then we say it is invalid file. So if you see that, see the output. This we are uploading, and then its size is also run. Then stored. This is stored as a temporary file with this name. Then when it is moved, it is the original name. We are moving it to the folder called upload. It is declared under the htdocs. If it is not that, see, invalid file. It is more than 600 KB. So it is not able to upload. because less than 30 KB only this file will allow to upload. So that is what we have given a check.